Let me discuss Bagel 1 versus Bagel 2 side by side, because that way you will be very clear that what Bagel 1 has added, Bagel 2 has added, and how it is different from Bagel 1. So let's go and take a look. First, take a look at the pillars. The Bagel 1 had only one pillar. What is that? Minimum capital requirement, so that you can safeguard yourself against the credit risk. Bagel 2 has three pillars: minimum capital requirement, which obviously was here also, and two additional: supervisory review and role, and the market discipline and disclosure. Supervisory review, you can think of it is as good as a regulatory body of the country taking a look at your practices, your financial practices. And market disclosure is like you are submitting several reports to the market, so that the investors and those who understand these business, they can take a look and make an expert comment, so that the whole industry understands the risk associated with you and probably can help you to improve your practice. So in simple words, Bagel 1 has only one pillar, Bagel 2 has three pillars. If you think of risk also, Bagel 1 talked of just the credit risk, whereas Bagel 2 talks of credit risk, operational risk, as well as market risk. So essentially, the risk wise also, it was only bothered about one particular risk, whereas Bagel 2 is bothered about the three risks. If you think of approach also, the Bagel 1 has only standard approach of measurement and capital calculation. You have seen in the last section, it's a standard approach that you classify assets into four categories and you calculate the asset. Whereas Bagel 2, what you will realize that you have multiple approach for actually for each kind of risk, be it credit risk, be it operational risk, or be it market risk. So you have multiple approach of calculating risk, and same way then accordingly associated capital requirement, that okay, for each risk how much capital is required. So that side by side Bagel 1 and Bagel 2. Let me just reiterate one particular term. Bagel 2 is more granular than Bagel 1, and even if you see just the standard approach of Bagel 2, you'll find the difference. Let me show you how. In Bagel 2, Bagel 1, irrespective of the rating of the bank, for each corporate you are supposed to keep 100% as the weightage, so that you can calculate 8% of that as the risk capital requirement. Whereas in Bagel 2, you will find there is a huge difference. It goes from 20% to as good as 150%. So even in standard approach, if you think of a standard approach of Bagel 2, it is far more granular than Bagel 1.